Henri Désiré Landru was France's most notorious serial killer. 100 years ago, he was operating in and around the Paris region, during and just after the First World War. He befriended women, preferably rich women. They were often lonely because most of the men were fighting and dying at the front. He lured them to his house in Gambé, 50 kilometers outside Paris. It was called the Villa Trique.
The war was a very significant factor in Landru being able to get away with so many murders. He was really unpoliced. In Gambé, there was one 73-year-old constable, and then the nearest gendarme was 4 miles away in Oudin. So he could come and go as he pleased, really with nobody paying any attention to him.
In 1919, he was arrested and put on trial. He was accused of killing 10 women and one man. Their names and the exact time of their death were found in one of Landru's notebooks. Some maintain that there wasn't enough proof to convict him. But newly found facts may indicate that he killed many more.
The police did not trace all the women that were on the files that Landru kept in his garage. There are records in the police archives in Paris showing quite clearly that they didn't trace 72 women. It doesn't mean that Landru killed those 72, but it does mean that the police didn't do a thorough investigation. It's very likely that Landru deposited the remains of the women, a lot of them, in this forest. It's very, very thick, wooded, and he wasn't monitored at all. There's one incident in particular, which was the doctor, Montaillet, who was cycling back to barracks in Versailles on the other side of the pond, 25 kilometres away. And he has a puncture in the middle of the night, and he is repairing the puncture on his bicycle. And Landru turns up in his camionette, doesn't see the doctor, and the doctor sees him carrying a very, very heavy package to the other side of the pond, disappearing behind some reeds, and then clearly dropping the package in the water. He hears the sound of the package being dropped. And then Landru comes back and drives back to Gambé.
The problem with the doctor's testimony was that it didn't fit the chronology of the kill list in Landru's notebook. But the discrepancies between the testimonies and the evidence were never investigated, and the fate of many women remains unknown. Yet Landru faced the heaviest punishment. On February the 25th, 1922, he was beheaded by the guillotine.